Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how to create this amazing zoom in towards Earth effect in After Effects. Okay, so I have 5 files imported into my project. This is a world map. This is a pin. Map of the moon. Photo of the sky at the night. Also my video of some kind of rainforest. So let's start. Let's just create a new composition. Let it be 4K, 10 seconds, okay. Okay, so I'm gonna put my world map over it and put the effect CC sphere. This gonna bend my layer on this sphere. As you can see, when I rotate here, it's gonna rotate that way. So then we don't do that. We're gonna open in our effect controls rotation panel, and here we can literally turn our Earth around. Okay, so we are going for the start with keyframing rotation Y. Let's fast forward for like, I don't know, 6 seconds, and make, for example, 50 degrees turn. So it's gonna look like that. For now, it's okay. Now I'm gonna create my little friend called Moon. So let's open our project panel, put Moon over a timeline, also add CC sphere. Let's go find our moon. We can see our moon here, but moon is a little smaller than the Earth. It's like, I think it's like that. So we can put it over here. At the first, we are going to also keyframe Y rotation. Let's put it here. And 50 degrees. So right now we are going to change the position of our moon. From here to here, our moon will travel like that. And in the middle, we're going to bend it a little. And now we are going to just adjust the handles.
Where's the handle?
Also remember, this space need to get bigger because the moon is going towards us. Now I'm gonna just change our scale. So from 20% is gonna get bigger to, for example, 25%. It doesn't need to be adequate to the real life, it's just animation. But remember to put linear keyframes here. The movement of the Earth, of the rotation, is always linear. It doesn't speed up at any moment. It doesn't slow down at any moment. It's always linear. So let's keep that in mind. Okay, so right now we are going to put our sky below. This is just the photo. It's not the video. I downloaded the photo because I wanted to show you how to animate the glowing stars on the single photo. So let's put effect glow on our layer, and we've clicked Alt option on the Mac. Let's click glow threshold, glow radius, and glow intensity. Okay, so this parameter corresponds about glowing. So we are gonna use the wiggle expression for these 3 parameters. Wiggle expression works like that. You write wiggle, open the bracket, and the first value is frequency. So how many times per second is that value gonna change? And the second is our value. So it means 5 times per second, our glow threshold going to change for 15. You can see it's not a real life. You just need to stop it, but you can see 67, 70, and here's 48. So let's write the wiggle expression for our other. Let's, for example, 5 times 10, And as you can see, glow intensity is very low values, so we're just gonna use wiggle 5.1. And now we are gonna create our camera. Let's put a new camera, and always remember when you use camera, as the camera controller, use null objects and pick whip our camera to our null object. We can change the name to camera controller, and remember to set our moon, our world, and our camera controller as 3D. Do not set the sky for the 3D, because the cosmos doesn't gonna zoom that fast as the world or the moon. We just gonna use a little scale all over it, like from 100 to 104%. Okay, so let's now open position for our camera controller, and for example towards 6 seconds we are gonna zoom in very much, like for example to that spot. So right now we are gonna do a transition from this to our, for example, rainforest, as me, because I wanted to zoom in to the forest. You can also zoom in to the town, to the center of Paris, to this Barcelona, to New York, as you want, but I wanted to do it for rainforest in Amazon. We are just gonna put it here. It's not gonna be a 3D layer, of course. Let's just push it here. We are going to create a little mask around the center. Let's keyframe our mask path. Let's move few frames forward, and let's push our mask far away from our screen. I'm doing that because I'm gonna use a high value mask feather, so we won't see anything on the edges. If I'm gonna put our point here and put like 500 of the mask feather, you're gonna see over edges. So I'm just going to push it here. Okay, let's make mask feather like 500, and how it's gonna look. Okay, let's just analyze that. Here our camera controller ends, so here our earth stops going forward, so we are gonna put our end frame for the mask here, but now it doesn't look natural because it's too big. So I'm gonna zoom in and make it much, much smaller. Oh, like that. Second frame, it's also too big. See, it's going that way. Yeah, we can even make it something like that. Yeah, that looks very good. So the last thing which I want to add is a pin on our globe. So let's start. Let's put our pin, make it 3D layer, make it a lot smaller. So let's start, I don't know, 10%. I think it's okay. Maybe a little too big, but I need to adjust it. Let's find our spot. I think, okay, it's this one. So I'm gonna put it here. I'm going to, with pan behind tool, change my anchor point to the bottom, to the middle bottom, or I can use my motion tools and just click here, and it's perfectly gonna line up. And I can easily rotate that, like that. So I'm gonna make it smaller, maybe 7%. Okay, I'm gonna make the 7% here. I'm gonna put 0, so it's going to show up. And now I'm gonna select these both keyframes And now with my Motion Tools plugin, I'm gonna add a link in the description where you can download this plugin. I'm gonna use Elastic. Elastic allows me to make this bouncy effect for my animations. I'm gonna put like, for example, 70 here. It's the power or the amplitude, and I'm gonna just change decay to 20. Okay, I think it's a little too big, so I'm gonna make it like 50. Okay, it's okay. But as you can see, our position of our pin, it's not perfect. It's not aligned with our earth, but unfortunately I can parent it to our world map, because parenting just goes to these effects in transform, and our rotation is always 0, 0, 0, because we are doing a rotation on effect CC sphere, and it's not gonna align. We are going to make it manually. Let's make it almost perfect. Okay, and we need to just change our size of our pin, because it's a lot too big, like to the 0.5%. Yeah, that's okay. Let's adjust the position, and we are gonna just fade it out at the end. And that's it. This is how you create this amazing zoom in transition from cosmos into, for example, drone footage of yourself in the backyard. The possibilities here are enormous. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Remember to subscribe our channel, and see you in the next video. Bye.